What does it mean to be a Rodriguez? That was so whack. Growing up was never easy for me. I had a lot of obstacles, and I was introduced to tragedy at a young age.
Do some push-ups with daddy.
What?
You better get that big butt out of here. You better get that big butt out of here. Get that big Batman butt out of here.
When I was born, I had a birth defect. It was called fibula hemimelia. Well, I was only born with a tibia bone. I only had two toes, no ankle, and my mother had to make a hard decision in 1988, what she should do, what her options were. And they decided amputation was the best route for me, that I would have a chance to be normal, whatever normal means, and the best quality life. Thank you. And give my leg. I mean my leg.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, help me. Thank you. We all want to feel like we're a part of something. And when you're a part of the community, it gives you a sense of confidence.
Ooh, I like that polo though. You look like bro, you're about to knock somebody out.
It's okay. I think showing emotion is okay. Being yourself is okay. Being different is okay. That's what's most important to me. And I feel like that's what's important to other people if they start to realize it. You need to know. You need others to give you some type of insight and confidence to let you know you can do things. I had to figure a lot of that out on my own. And my role in the prosthetic industry is to provide that service for others.
Hi, how are you? Good, thanks.
I had my amputation done in May of 2016, and it was all due to a circulation problem that I had in my leg. I wasn't getting a proper blood flow down to the bottom of my leg, and I unfortunately had a wound, and the wound turned into an infection, and this was my best option at that time, was the amputation.
Mr. Martin.
Yes, sir.
Anthony Morano.
How are you? Nice to meet you again.
Let's go on inside. Let's see what we can do for you today. Come on.
Today.
I'm good, baby. How you doing?
Good, man. Good.
How you feeling now? So you excited about getting your leg?
Yeah, man. I can't wait. I'm looking forward to it. I can't believe it's almost been a year, man.
Big change since I first met you.
Yeah. What was it? April 15, 2016?
Something like that. I was looking at the photo, like, you know how Facebook and everything gives you your memories.
I
was looking at the timeline. I was like, man, craziness. It's been a while.
I was involved in a motorcycle accident in April of 2016. Which has left me with an amputation above the knee on my right leg. I woke up out of a coma and Rob was standing there. And it almost felt like a dream.
So what's up, boy?
What's going on?
Good to see you. You got the Xbox in here too? I didn't know you were that lit.
Yeah, I hooked it up. They got it for me for my birthday.
Oh, nice. What are you playing?
2K, I got the Grand Theft Auto.
Whoa, you got the 2K? Mm-hmm. You might have to come see you in some 2K. I currently work as a prosthetic educator. I've been in the industry for about 4 years, and business development, marketing, patient advocacy is my job title, but helping people receive a limb is different than selling a car. It's different than just a product. It's something that's an attachment. It's a part of someone's life. It's important for me to try to get them to get used to what's going to come and to just prepare them as best as I can, living with limb loss.
I still feel like I'm having a very rough time. And even when I get the leg, it's just one of those things you're gonna have to go through with. People who have had this done to them, like me, you're 28 years old, you've had 28 years with two legs, and now all of a sudden you have one. It's still not enough time to comprehend it. There are days where I wake up and I think I have my other leg sometimes. I go to walk and I fall down, and it reminds me that I have to come face to face with this one day. One day I'm gonna have to face these feelings mm-hmm. of being an amputee.
Come.
Okay.
You popping? We're popping up?
Yeah.
All right, girl. That's what I'm talking about.
There we go. Big steps.
There we go. Perfect, Jane.
You receive your prosthesis.
Okay, give me
it does not walk for you. I try to let people know that you have to put a lot of time, a lot of work.
Seven.
You have to want to walk. You have to want to get back to work. You have to want it.
Yeah, let's take a walk.
Let's take a walk.
Looking good, looking good.
Just stand up for me.
Yeah, yeah.
Good.
Some of the impact that I feel like that I've made on some of the people that I've been working with. Frank, for instance, he was the equipment manager of my sled hockey team. But then when he lost his leg in that unfortunate turn of events, we became close. I was honored to be there the next day right after his amputation, and he was already up. So your fit looks on point, right? It felt good,
yeah,
right?
It felt great. Yeah,
a soccer fit, that's a tight fit is everything you want, you know. I told you, it'd be in no time, you'd be walking.
Yeah.
So you're gonna get all the PT help here, like you know, you already know. But doing these, even in the walker, bending down, doing a bunch of dips. But you're looking good, bro.
Thanks, man. Thanks,
I love it. I love it. The growth that you're getting, man. I'm hyped.
It's so hard to lose a limb. It can be a car accident. It can be cancer. There are so many things that life brings upon you. You know, losing a limb is like losing a part of yourself. It's my job to let them know that there's opportunity out there for you and that I will fight for you for every component, for your foot, for your knee, for your socket. You know, whatever the question that you have, you're not facing this battle alone.
What you do every day of your lives, there are a lot of people shut down in a home somewhere and just giving up. You show them that regardless of the disability, there's no reason to ever give up.
I gotta get like you. I gotta get like you in life.
What I realize is because, especially on this leg, you probably got the same thing. It's so much harder because of the weight. I can whip faster on my amputated side because of less weight. But when I'm going to, it's harder for me on this side.
It's harder for me on this side.
Really? One of the challenging things for people is acceptance. Acceptance is hard as an amputee, accepting that your body is different, accepting your new lifestyle, accepting who you are, accepting that you might not be able to do everything that you could or the exact way that you did, but you can do anything you want if you put your mind to it.
There are levels. There are levels to being paralyzed.
There are levels to the triple lie.
I know. Damn, Patrick, you got to hold up the whole thing, buckling in like that?
What I like to say, and I'm trying to get Amazon to patent it, is when you're on the ice, your disabilities disappear. And I'm proud of all of you. I love you all. Thank you so much. Woo! Let's go. Saddle up.
Hey, guys.
Underneath, left, left, left.
Uh-oh, Disco Robbie, king of the hustle.
One salad, Robbie.
Growing up was my hardest time. For a child, you know, you just want to fit in. But for me, my situation or my circumstances were never like that. I was about 3 years old, 2 days before Christmas. My house burned down. I lost my grandmother in that fire. And I just remember my mother waking me up, carrying me outside. And I said, "Where are you going?" As she started to proceed back into the house, and she said, "I'm going to get your leg." That kind of changed the dynamics of my life. My parents were never married. I never saw them date. And once our house burned down, my mother really pushed so that I could have the best life possible. But that kept her out of the house. She was working two jobs to just kind of keep a roof over my head. I never was in any one place for too long. I was never in anyone's one care for too long, which then led to me being abused by a family member, and I grew up very quickly. My mom and I say this all the time, it's kind of like we grew up together because she was young, I was young, and we went through all these experiences and had to figure them out on our own. I couldn't rely on anyone or anything. I had to be my own man. I use my job as therapy. I need people to know that life is not over and that I've been there. I had no control over what happened to me in my life. I had no control over what happened to my leg. But the one thing I could control was my attitude. It took me a long time to figure that out. And that's 100%. No one could take that away from me. Your mind is the most powerful thing you have. Come right here, come right here, come right here. Come next to me. Let's do it. Put your shoulder, put your, here you go, like this. Mary asked me to do a little bit of speaking in regards to leadership. And I've always felt like a leader. And being a leader is really, in my mind, is being a listener. The biggest thing is trying to empower others. And I think that's what we're all here to do, right? That's what Camp No Limits is about, right? Yep. Obviously showing that we have no limitations, but also empowering each other, because I think that's the most important thing.
There you go.
There's one thing that I noticed is true for all amputees, and I think it applies to all realms of activities in life. You have several thresholds that you gotta surpass.
Yep.
The first one is super hard.
Yeah.
And you push, and you push, and a lot of people give up before they surpass that one because they assume the second one is gonna be just as high. They're not taking consideration the learning curve.
Yeah. One, two, three, four. One more. Ah, that was it though. That was the one. That was it. Six was good. I like that. That was good.
That is what I try to talk people into, like, hey, don't give up. And don't judge the first threshold. Don't think that the other ones are just as difficult because they're not.
You know, yeah. It used to take me 10 minutes to put my leg on. Now it's taking me about two. Used to take me two minutes to get into the car. Now it takes me 30 seconds, 40 seconds.
And you called me up like, man, I can't get in the car with this thing.
Yeah.
Dude,
yeah.
It's been a month. I mean, that was a day. Yeah. Now it's been a month, right?
So, yeah.
And now imagine where you'd be in a year.
Running.
Let's go, D. Hey, give me a little back. Hey.
I tell people who are looking at the situation fresh, there are going to be bad days. There are going to be days where you feel you have nobody in your life. And, you know, I've been there. You know, I felt like I didn't want to be here. That's the great thing about life. Just when you think that life can't be anything more for you, you have something as beautiful as a little girl came into my life. Princess time, not piggy time. I'd like to say life drags you down just to bring you back up.
Are you chilled?
I guess I ate.
Good job.
Did you talk to your brother?
Yeah.
When I came back to my first practice, when I had promised myself that I would walk in, it was quite an emotional day. I never realized how much I really meant to so many people.
Are those rollerblade or
these are regular
hockey, ice hockey?
They were ice hockey.
Where'd you get those at?
Larry had got one. He had one.
Okay.
That's all I needed.
Robert always keeps reminding me, you're back to a normal life. You just walk with an artificial leg now.
Right.
He's become almost like a son that I've never had.
Exactly.
It's like the old cliche of he was stuck in a foxhole, who would you want with you? I would want Robert there with me. He's gonna make something positive happen out of something that's gonna enable everybody to get up and move, to get up out of that foxhole and continue on with life.
Yeah, but
you got a lot of speed too.
Let me tell you something. I don't want you to be disappointed in me. I only use the two sticks down here, places like this. Otherwise, I'm down to one stick or no stick at all.
No, you told me that. No stick at all?
Yeah, no stick at all.
That's what I like to see.
Every now and then, it's a little hairy, but... Yeah.
Pedro and I were talking upstairs. He was dropping a lot of gems, and he was saying that people get caught up in the beginning process, right? So the beginning is why people quit. Because when you get to the beginning, you think it's the hurdle's this high, and you have to jump so far, and why do it anyway? Because if I do get that far and then get to the next level, then it's almost impossible. But in our case, the first step, or amputee joke, the first hop is always the hardest.
Follow behind me?
Well, follow behind me, but you gotta hop. cool.
So you just take that jump, you know, close your eyes, and don't quit on anything.
That's so funny.
Follow me.
All right, go. How many, 20?
I have a firm quote, if you believe, then other people will believe too. So if you believe in yourself, other people will believe in you too, and that's being a leader.
Six, seven.
So come here, you wanna help me make some eggs? One of the first things when I had my kids was make sure that they had all their limbs intact. So as soon as we were in the hospital room, I was like, all right, two legs, two arms, great, I'm good. So they're already better off than me.
I told you, there you go, harder. Good job, thank you.
I pride myself on educating my kids, and they know what amputee is, what a prosthetic device is, you know, what I go through, so that this way they see someone else in the street and they know that it's not easy. So they see everything that I'm going through and that I'm overcoming this. I'm hoping that whatever they go through, they know that if my dad got up every day, put on his leg, went to work, handled his business, that I can do whatever I have to do, despite what's in front of me. If you show love and give love, then you will get love. And I want to be able to continue doing what I'm doing. I want to be able to take it to another level, and I want people to recognize the efforts that I put in, and then I want them to turn around and do that for someone else.
So proud of you, so proud of you.
Easy, bro.
Always, you too, man. Always.
Ready? Hands in.
Have a good day, everybody.
Good day. One, two, three. Rodriguez team.
Homie.
Okay, I'll hold you.
Robert Rodriguez is a young man who came from nothing, who made something out of nothing.
Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me. Cause I want you and I need you. And I'm down for you always, KB. Do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me. Cause I want you and I need you. And I'm down for you always. Looking new me is really still grim me. I swear you gotta feel me before they try and kill me. Thank you.